Hey everybody, DJJ here, and today, there it is, DDJ-ERGO. It is out. I want to go over it with you. Got a couple of cool functions, features, but just want to kind of explain what we got in front of you. As you can see, I'm going to try to pick up some of the angles here. This is a exquisitely beautiful controller. It's not only about the function of it, it's about the looks of it, it's about the appearance of it, it's about how it responds to you, the user. It's about all the functions that you're gonna need. Got some insane lighting on here that's actually, I'm gonna explain in a little bit. You'll see some of the lighting will change. And that's very important because it tells you when effects are on and filters and when your mixing is there. And this is great if you're just getting into DJing. If you're already established in DJing, you're going to know what to do with it. It's laid out just like the CDJ series. So really in the middle, you've got a two-channel mixer. On either side, you have really set up just like a regular CDJ would be. You've got looping function, got your cue and play, got your touch-sensitive platter if you want to do some scratching. And up here, you've got sample bank, hot cues, and your effects. And I'll go over that in a second. I'm running this with the Pioneer DDJ-ERGO skin. As you can see, that's running Virtual DJ-LE. Virtual DJ, if you're not familiar with it, is an MP3 music management program that allows you to play music. So you've got two players. I can also run to four players. If you look here, you see A and C, B and D. It's because this is actually set up to control four decks. There's some files out on the internet right now. There's a TSI file for Tractor. So you could run this with Tractor. It comes loaded up and bundled with Virtual DJ LE, which is a great program. I can run this with video. I can run this scratching setup. You see right here in the middle of the screen, got set up for video. Got it set up where I can run in what they call scratch mode. And I can do it as an internal mixer. You also notice down here, I'm going to move the first volume fader, bring down the second volume fader. I'm going to move my crossfader. You see everything I'm doing on the controller being mimicked up here. So this is controlling this. Very simple. So starting over here, got my play pause button, got my cue so I can set a cue point. Let me give it a little volume so you can just hear this. There we go. Right above here, I've got my shift button. That's going to come into play, especially up here when I'm controlling things. As you can see, I'm scrolling through my playlist. When you hit shift, any of the underlying writing that you see in gray, that's when those functions come into effect. When the shift button is hit, that changes some of the things on the controller. So again, anytime you see any of the light gray writing, you're going to end up controlling those things when you hit shift. This way it gives you a little more form, a little more functionality when you're dealing with things. I'm gonna come up here, got auto looping, cut my loop. Do whatever I'd like with looping. Really cool, I've got my hot cue set up here. So I've got one hot cue, got two. And I can keep those saved and called up. This is cool, you're gonna see the screen change. Comes loaded with four samples. I have four sample banks here on this side. Then on this side I have four more. So I can call these up independent of the music. I also can control the volume of them. So let's say this first one you see right here. Volume comes up, goes down, controlled right off here. Yeah, I can also easily record samples. Not a problem. So whenever I want to do that, set them up and just run them. Right now I'm using a flanger. It's hard to see on the screen, I think, because of the lighting. I apologize for that. But if you look closely under FX, you start to see a couple of those knobs turning. They're actually affecting my flanger right there. It does come loaded with effects. Probably the coolest effect is this, the beat grid. You can change the pattern. Got my backspin. And my break. And again, really cool effects. Let you customize them, set them up any way you'd like. So everything I'm going to need to do on the surface of the controller is going to mimic everything that I'm going to do in virtual. So this is just a really quick intro for you. I'm going to go over some other functions with this, do a little mix for you in a little bit. But I just wanted to get this out there early on in the game so you could take a look at things, make some decisions. Of course, if you have any questions about this, post them right under here. Be happy to get back to you and help you as best I can. And again, this is a little intro for you on the Pioneer DDJ ERGO controller. Thank you for watching. Okay, just a couple things I went into. Got the light on the platter here. See the lights moving. This is pulse mode. You can also see down here, right at the top there, see that blinking LED. This is so I can keep an observation of my beats so that when I'm doing a mix, I'm going to get that on either side. Once everything's synced up, that's actually going to start syncing together. So I want to do it without headphones and without audio, just to kind of get things right where they need to be. Okay. Okay, you see I'm starting to get the pattern going. You also see the wheels are now the same amount of brightness. And again, one of the cool things is, let's say I put a filter on. Whenever you engage the filter, you get that spinning on the wheel. That's on the low pass, high pass. And again, spins in the direction of the filter knob. So let's say you were doing a mix and you come out of it, come over. You would know you still have your filter on, even just the slightest bit, because that wheel's gonna give you that indication. The other really cool function that I like is the ability to call up the two effects. You have your two banks of effects, effects one, effects two. What you can do is preset, so you have a beat grid going in a flanger. Then when you engage this during a track, it pulls up the effect on that side, as well as the other effects, so you can lay effects over each other, which is a really cool function. Gives you the ability to hit both effects on one side. So I already know what effect I have locked in here. I have the beat grid set up. So that's my effect one. Effect two, got a flange going. So that's really cool, I like that. Really good function. Again, I can move things, I can change my pulse mode, the tempo mode, lock key, which is really your master tempo setup. So it's a really nice little controller here. The other really great thing is, if you notice in the back, I just have this one USB cable. I don't have a power source. It's actually running off my laptop. So if my laptop's fully charged with this, I can go out and play. Do it through the headphones, I'm done. I don't need any external power of any kind. Even at a small gig, say do a powerless powered speaker, do a wireless setup with it. Over here you'd plug your lav setup. Over here on your speaker, you could actually put the transmitter, receiver, boom, you're done. So you could actually do a small gig on a beach or something, you'd be good to go. So again, just wanted to show you a couple more functions and features here on the DDJ ERGO DJ controller.